Going to talk about three meditations. This follows the last two classes. Today is an overall summary, so it might be a little bit more detailed, a little bit harder. Today there's five sets of three. Three truth, three delusions, three meditations, three wisdoms, and three virtues. So if you understand the system of cultivation, you know the entire truth about the universe and how we can cultivate into Buddhahood. First, we come to understand the three truths of the universe. The first truth is called the ultimate truth. Like we said before, it's a truth about emptiness. Everything is based on cause and conditions. Cause conditions are forever changing, so nothing is permanent in our lives. This body is gonna get old, it's gonna die. It's not permanent, we just use it. So in its essence, it's empty in nature. That's what we call the ultimate truth. If you understand this, then you will not be attached to this body or to whatever that's happening to you in this lifetime, and you will have peace and happiness. So let go of all attachment and the idea of the ego and the me. The second truth is called the conventional truth. Everything's empty in essence, but it has its physical appearance and forms. We cannot deny it temporarily exists. We have to eat, we have to sleep, we have to make money. We are still on this earth and doing conventional life. So even though it's empty, we be the best that we can be and lead a great life and be compassionate and help all people. So that's the conventional truth. The third truth is called the middle way. The middle way truth is a balance of the emptiness and the conventional truth. It's an enlightenment of your own Buddha nature. When you're over here, you're very well-rounded. You will understand the meaning of equanimity. You treat everybody the same because we're all empty in essence. We're all together as one. We're all the Buddha nature. So that's when you're truly enlightened, when you know the middle way. Originally, we're all Buddha, but we deluded ourselves. We have three delusions that clouded our minds. That's why we are like this now. We become a mundane person. The first delusion is called false perception, subjective thinking. Our perceptions are seeing the world with our own lenses. We see the world based on our own ego and our perception of things. There's this mom. One day she went to see the older son. He was holding a book and sleeping. The mom's like, he's so lazy. Every time he studies, he falls asleep. So he doesn't like the older son. And then he went to the younger son's room. The younger son is also holding a book and sleeping. She loves the younger son. She said, oh, he studies so hard. Even when he's sleeping, he's trying to study. Okay, so she saw two of the same thing, but she got two different conclusions. Because we're full of ourselves and we have our way of seeing things. But what is the truth? You have never seen the reality of things because you're seeing through your own ego. So that's what we call it, the false perception. It's a subjective thinking. That clouds us from seeing the ultimate truth. The second kind of delusion is called the subtle and coarse illusion. We have very refined delusions, as numerous as the dust and the sand. We have so much misjudgment and discrimination about everything. This is coming from selfishness or selfish thought. This doesn't have to be the selfishness, but it's about overall misjudgment and discrimination. There was a monk, he's been in the mountain meditating inside a cave for many, many years. Monkeys
bring him fruits for him to eat. So they actually help him survive. Every day he would just eat one fruit that the monkey bring. After years of cultivation, he finally come back to the monastery. One day someone came and gave offering to the monk very precious peaches. The monk said, oh, can you bring these peaches to the monkeys? And his disciples like, isn't that kind of wasteful? They're very, very precious. The monk said, so giving it to you is not wasteful? Why do you think giving it to the monkey is wasteful? Because that's our own perception, our subtle and coarse illusion. We have our own thinking. We think, you know, giving to human is not wasteful. Giving to a monkey is wasteful. We have a lot of delusion. We just don't know. We never realize that. So that clouds us, so we don't see the conventional truth. The third kind of delusion is called ignorance. All our wandering thoughts are ignorance. All your thoughts, no matter it's good or bad, is all wandering thoughts. When you are not fully mindful of the present moment, you are not awakened. You are still ignorant. This clouds us from seeing the middle way truth. Okay, we are like this now. What do we have to do? We have to practice the three meditations. That will help you see the truth again. First, we practice the void meditation. Void meditation is seeing the nothingness, seeing the emptiness. Just like when we're meditating, you know, you're seeing the feel and your body disappears. That is to help you see what is the world like when I don't have the ego. It actually gives you a great freedom that you don't have to have the idea of the self. For example, if someone insults you, this is emptiness. There's not a me being insulted and there's not this person insulting me because the idea of me is all empty. This is a great way of meditating. And the second kind of meditation is called the unreal meditation. Everything is empty, but it has its unreal temporary existence. It's not real because it's temporary. When you're acting, you're playing a movie, you want to play a great movie. You don't want to play a movie that, you know, nobody wants to see. In this world, we still go with the flow, go with what the world says. For example, is there Santa Claus? We don't tell kids it's fake, right? We still give gifts and we still put gifts under the tree. We know it's not real, but we still go with it because we want to make everyone happy. When you come to this kind of unreal meditation and you will come to the conventional truth, you will love everybody in your life without any attachment to them or to yourself. That is a great wisdom when you can practice unreal meditation. And the last meditation is called the Ming meditation. Ming, again, is a balance of the emptiness and whatever it appears right now, the temporary existence. You want to go with the world, go with the flow, enjoy the party, but you don't have the idea of me. You don't have all these subjective thinkings and emotions. That way, you will understand the truth of the middle way. When you practice the three kinds of meditation, you will come to the three wisdoms. So this is the result. The three wisdom and the three virtue are the result of your cultivation. You will come to the general and all knowledge wisdom. When we get rid of our false perception and subjective thinking by practicing the void meditation, we come to the general and all knowledge wisdom, knowing the ultimate truth, and develop the virtue of prajna. Prajna means insight. True insight is when you understand emptiness. That's a virtue we gain and develop. The second wisdom you will gain is called the differentiation wisdom. You will know all the conventional truth, but you differentiate without judgment and discrimination. because you don't have yourself involved and you are able to love everyone. Some people like to eat noodles, some people like to eat buns, some people like to eat rice. Everybody's different, but you can go with everybody because you know the conventional truth. That's a real wisdom when you can get along with everyone, hang out with anybody, survive in all situations, and you are still an enlightened person, compassionate, and help everybody. And you will gain the deliverance virtue. This is a freedom from your subtle and coarse illusion. You're free from all the judgment that's clouding your mind, and you will see the conventional truth. And lastly, when you do the mean meditation and get rid of your ignorance, you will gain the overall and perfect wisdom. You are now one with the universe. You're actually able to love everyone and have no problem in your life. This time you become real Buddha and you gain the Dharmakaya. Dharmakaya means your Buddha nature. You are not the physical body anymore. You are the spiritual body. You're awakened and you're fully enlightened. That's when we become a real Buddha. So just want to let you know this actually is what we have innately. It's not someone giving it to you, it's what you have originally. So have confidence in yourself that we're all Buddhas to begin with. What's actually not real? The three delusions are not real. You just gain it along the way when you keep living in this world and you become deluded, but they are not real. The real you is you have the three wisdom and you have the three virtues. When you go to a temple, usually you will see three doors. There are usually three arches. And what the three arches mean? It means the void meditation, the unreal meditation, and the mean meditation, because that's the gist of our cultivation. Okay, so that's the class for today. Thank you for listening. Omitofo.